We've just gone to BedZED.
Here we are in one of BedZED's really nice apartments. We're looking at a house that doesn't need central heating.
Just going around the site and looking at the different things that they have has given me a lot more ideas on just how simple it is to actually make adjustments to more sustainable and green living. It looks just like your average house, except that the materials are a lot more sustainable and a lot more green.
We produced recently a report called the Offshore Valuation. The headline finding of the report is that by using just a third of the UK's offshore renewable resource, we could become a net electricity exporter.
We're in Bristol today, and this is Bristol City Council. They recently allowed a biofuel plant to be built in Avonmouth, which is really close to here. And they were basically deciding on how much of the biofuels were actually to be transported by road.
They're obviously all
behind us. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see it on film, but there's a lovely wind farm. I've been personally very impressed by everything I've seen.
You have to leave a space between the insulation and the brick.
They're taking something that is 140 to 150 years old and actually turning it into something that is going to be useful 50 years and going forward from that.
We've just got back from our trip to Drax power station. It was a really interesting trip for me. I think I took a lot away from it. And it was just really interesting to see how people can be so ingrained in what's clearly a very intensive and dirty way of producing electricity.
It's interesting to see how infrastructure that was built 50 or 60 years ago is still relevant today. But then you can also see how vulnerable it is.
They were really keen to think about different solutions, which was really, really inspiring.
Oh, we're pretty close.
There we are.
There's a lot of uncertainty and that's scary. I felt quite scared walking around. When you're getting all of that PR and you're getting all of that spin from them, of course you're going to believe at the end of the day that it's really, really safe.
50% of DECC's budget goes into decommissioning nuclear power plants. Important public services are going to be cut while we're paying to clean up private companies' nuclear waste.
There is this general, we want to start off figuring out this collective identity and we'll be young voters, we're the young and future electorate. I think we're far more than that as well, and I think we're the same.